Hey guys, it is Friday night, November something, I don't know the date. But I'm calling this a Carmichael Davis Show video blog, but it feels a little weird because it's not really anything to do with the show. But a lot of you might wonder and have asked why I missed Thursday night's program. Thursday afternoon, or on Wednesday I should say, we had our second pediatrician appointment for the baby, and she's supposed to get a half an ounce a day, which, because our last appointment was 2 weeks earlier, would have been 7 ounces she should have gained. She actually lost 3. So they decided to put her on formula, and in addition to the breast milk, and she kept throwing that up the next day, so they decided to admit her to where we are now in the pediatric unit of Mercy San Juan Hospital. They thought she had something called pyloric stenosis. I always get that name wrong, but I think that's right. Which is it's the place between the stomach and the bowels. It's a little valve that lets food pass through. And I thought hers might be too small, and that's why she was regurgitating food. Needless to say, when we got here, they had to do an ultrasound on her belly, which they weren't able to get a successful view. So they repeated it again this morning. Excuse me. And if that had been what it was, we would have been transferred to UC Davis and she would have had to undergo surgery. As it is, the ultrasound came back negative. She's been keeping her fluids down, which is a great sign, and she actually gained 3 ounces. Is that right? 3 ounces today, which, you know, half ounce a day, she gained 3 ounces, so we're on the right track. So we're going into another night here at the hospital, and we'll be here tomorrow. Hopefully we can check out tomorrow, but we won't know that till then. We may be here all weekend. So needless to say, you know, it's been a pretty scary last couple of days. Other than all the other stuff you go through, the worst part has been, you know, watching her be stuck about 15 times with a needle to try to run an IV into her, which is horrible. And if you ever have kids and babies and they give you the option to go into the room or be outside and listen, don't do it, because it'll stick with you forever. Thank God they don't remember it. So as I've said to a couple people, those of you with kids will get this, those of you without will get it someday. You go through your entire life, my 30 some odd years I've gone through and got a pretty good grasp on my emotions. But then you have a kid and you realize that there's this whole new set of emotions that you never even knew you had, a whole new level of terror, a whole new level of fear, and especially a whole new level of helplessness. And that's kind of what we've been dealing with. So Melissa's been a rock, and we've kind of been dealing with that with each other, and obviously going through the pangs of, you know, are you good enough? Are you doing the right thing? Did you do something wrong? But what are you going to do, you know? Bottom line is, it's one thing if it's you, it's another thing if it's a helpless little baby. So it's been a tough couple of days, and that's why I've been gone, and hopefully by the time you guys see this or hear my show on Monday, I'll have great news and everything will be wonderful and great. But, you know, this is a video log of events, and I logged her birth, and she's, you know, obviously my life's a big part of the show, her life's going to be a big part of the show. So I'd be remiss if I didn't do this. So I'll take the camera here real quick and come over here, and you can see what I see. Here's her IV, and she's currently passed out. But as you can see over here, she's all stuck up and sitting there. So. It's a tough thing. It's not an easy thing to do, but we have a pretty good we're a pretty good
understanding of this hospital now that we spent so much time here. Food's not that bad. It's actually pretty good. And, you know, you just, you do what you can do. So, that's that. That's the report here Friday night. You'll probably be seeing this, hopefully, if I'm out of here, if we're all out of here Sunday. But I mean, you know, my world works in fantasy, you know, who got the base hit, who scored the winning touchdown, how the Kings are passing the ball. It's a wonderful thing for all of us to be able to work in the fantasy world, and sports are a great thing to be able to take your mind off of things. And, you know, you say you live and die with your teams. I say that all the time. I live and die with the Kings. But, you know, it took having a kid for me to realize that that's just a saying. I don't live and die with a sport. You know, I live and die with what we're looking at right now. And I know every parent understands what I'm saying. So, that's that. That's video blog. I don't know what it is. Number 6. We're all very tired here, obviously. It's been a rough couple days. And, we will talk to you Monday and be back with something, I'm sure, a lot more exciting for video blog number 7. For those of you who have said that my video blogs oftentimes do not deal with the show stuff and oftentimes will delve off into other goofy things, well, this obviously is one of those, and that's the price you pay for putting your life out on the radio, is sometimes you do things like that. Obviously, you can tell by my hair. I'm not really worried about appearance right now, but it's my life. It's what we're going through. It's what's happening. And, all of you that listen and call in and have been a part of the show for so long, I understand that the show and all of you are a huge personal part of my life that you know, I look forward to spending time with every day. So obviously you're going to see some behind the scenes stuff that whatever is out there. So that's that. I've rambled, but I'm delirious, so what do you want? We'll see you next week, and hope you guys all have a wonderful weekend. So peace out, dogs. We'll see you soon. Lights will